Hosea?
Hey, Arthur.
Come on! If we're gonna make it to this party, we sure as shit better clean up a little.
So we're doing this?
Oh, yeah. Old friend Dutch van der Linde is finally showing his true colors. Social climbing. Oh.
Old Signor Bronte, that horrendous snake, has invited us to the...
Away, please, gentlemen. Signor Bronte will be so pleased that you made it.
We are honored to be here.
That's wonderful, wonderful. Come, this way. What a beautiful evening it shall be. Mr. Bronte is a very good friend with the mayor. Good evening, Pierre.
Signor Napoli?
As long as the mayor behaves himself, you know. Mr. Bronte, he has that thing, you know. Respect.
Jose, Bill, you join the party. We'll meet you out back after we pay our respects to Senor Bronte.
Gumga?
We'll meet you out in the balcony when you're done.
Boys, you've arrived, and you've washed per la prima volta questo mese, senza dubbio.
This is quite a party you've invited us to.
Yes, quite something, although I'm not quite sure what.
So... Sand and...
The high society.
Yes, apparently so.
And all these people, these are friends of yours, Senor Bronte.
No, not quite, not quite. But they certainly are afraid of me.
I'll show you to the party, gentlemen, if you'll kindly follow me. Gentlemen, enjoy your evening and welcome once again to Santa Nina. Ciao, ciao.
Gentlemen, let's go ingratiate ourselves.
Evening, friend.
Okay. Go find the mayor if you can and stay out of trouble and steal nothing unless it's information.
Of course.
Jose, you go find us someplace to rob. Bill, go make us some new friends. I'm gonna find out if old Cornwall and what's his name, Milton, knows we're here. Gentlemen, be well.
Ooh, outrageous. These dancers. Well, I mean, if that's French culture for you, sign me up for French lessons.
Gentlemen, I hope you're having a fine evening.
Would you like tickets? Mr. Mayor,
wonderful to see you. What?
Lemieux, this intellectual here was just insulting me regarding the Redskin.
I did no such thing. But, Mr. Lemieux, I suggested that all of us as Americans had a duty to take care of people living in this land. And that extends to Saint Denis.
It ain't complex, Lemieux. And only an idiot like you, buddy, would try to make it so.
I will not deny idiocy, sir, but perhaps now is not the time.
Typical pansy!
You are drunk, Ferdinand.
I'm not drunk, you fool. But this man loves darkies.
Hey, you are pretty drunk. Yeah, what say you and me cool off?
How do you do?
Get your hands off me.
Come on, sleep it off. Sit down and calm down. Count to 1,000. Then you can rejoin the party. Evening all.
How do you do?
How are you all doing?
Thank you, sir.
My pleasure.
Henri Lemieux. I hope you're enjoying my party.
The mayor.
Allegedly.
There's quite a place you got here.
It's not mine, and the city is horribly in debt, but we can still put on a good show. Do you know Evelyn Miller?
My lord. The writer?
Well, we seem to have another deranged drunkard on our hands.
Shall we?
Oh, my lord, they're fantastic.
Good evening.
Beautiful.
Bonjour.
How are you?
Evening, sir.
Evening, ma'am.
How do you do?
Hi there. Sir.
Beautiful.
Hello, ma'am.
Hello,
ma'am.
Hello, sir.
How do you do, ma'am?
Bonjour,
evening,
monsieur.
Sir.
Hello, my dear.
Hello.
How's things?
This place hasn't got the
You
better.
Look like a man on a mission.
No problems?
Everything's fine. We have the place well secured.
Good. Mr. Bronte has a habit of wandering about and reading whatever he likes.
We're watching him and his men like hawks.
Thank you, Mr. Terrapin.
Hey! Is everything taken care of? The telephone, it keeps ringing.
The mayor said he will sign later. Marie! Marie! Find that little reprobate Jip and beat him! I will not have standard slip in this house! Have you lost your mind? I said, have you lost your mind? Come here. Come here. Look at me. Look at me. Who do you think you are? This area is not meant for the likes of you. You know this. The standards in this house are slipping. This is a final warning to you, miss. A final warning. Now get out of my sight.
Mr. Leviticus Cornwall. Top secret. Extremely confidential. Very interesting.
Find anything?
I think so.
Nothing. This town is a waste of time.
Maybe not.
Arthur? Gentlemen, I think we're done here.
What did you find out?
There's plenty of money moves through here, of course, and I think I found out how we can grab some of it. A big bank. Real one, I mean. But not yet.
A city bank?
Maybe. And a stuffed one. If we're gonna leave, that could be the one thing we need.
There's also that trolley car station Senor Bronte told us about, and I heard about a high-stakes poker game. Come on.
Here comes Lenny. All right. Let's get in. Go home!
Oh, I ain't never felt so awkward in all my life. All them folk all so pleased with themselves. Oh, high society's pigeon shit. If you ask me, it's more like torture.
Well, that's sort of the point, isn't it? Let the people torture themselves.
Here's them papers I took.
Anybody see you take this?
I don't think so.
I might have an idea. Let me think on it. Interesting times.
I guess. So what's next? Dancing lessons? Deportment?
More along the lines of armed robbery. Jose is handling reconnaissance on the bank. He and Abigail are gonna run some distractions, see how the law reacts.
Good.
Oh, and I spoke to Evelyn Miller. Fine man. Here helping the Indian chief we saw.
Yeah, I met him too, with the mayor.
He's lobbying officials in Saint-Denis on their behalf. Maybe we could help.
Maybe.
Now, I think there's a lot of money on the riverboat. A lot of money. And Trelawney, he's investigating for us. He says to meet him at the tailor's.
Okay.
One big score down here, Arthur, and we disappear. We are almost heading home.
Where is home?
I don't know. Exactly. But I can smell it. I'm gonna go investigate this trolley thing old Bronte was talking about.
Okay.
Hey, Arthur.
Come on! If we're gonna make it to this party, we sure as shit better...
This way, please, gentlemen. Senior Bronte will be so pleased that you made it.
We are honored to be here.
That's wonderful, wonderful. Come, come, this way. What a beautiful evening it shall be. Mr. Bronte is a very good friend with the mayor. Good evening, Pierre.
Senor Napoli?
As long as the mayor behaves himself, you know. Mr. Bronte, he has that thing, you know. Respect.
Jose, Bill, you join the party. We'll meet you out back after we pay our respects to Senor Bronte.
Come, come.
We'll meet you out in the balcony when you're done.
Ah, the angry cowboys, you are right.
I'll show you to the party, gentlemen, if you'll kindly follow me. Gentlemen, enjoy your evening and welcome once again to Saint-Denis. Ciao, ciao.
Gentlemen, let's go ingratiate ourselves. Okay. Go find the mayor if you can and stay out of trouble and steal nothing unless it's information.
Of course.
Jose, you go find us someplace to rob. Go make us some new friends.
Can I interest you in a glass of champagne?
I mean, modern art is all very well, but my daughter could do better.
Oh, you're not such a Philistine as all that,
sure.
Marie.
No,
fine evening to you.
Not much of a Philistine.
How you doing?
Had some starts, but okay, I guess.
Good evening. I like you, mister. You have a kind face.
Oh, that's quite unfair.
Well, hello.
Well,
gentlemen.
Good luck to you.
Featherstone Chambers.
How are you?
Pleased to meet you.
Heston James.
What a beautiful evening.
Sure.
You're very unkind, Marie.
I am honest. Where is that waiter?
Champagne, sir?
Me too.
How is your husband, Dolores? I hear he is much improved.
He's in Tunis, I believe. I do wish he'd hurry up and
die. You fool!
Camilla McClure!
Can I help you, sir?
Well, I'm not quite sure yet.
Hi there.
Albert Dan.
Je vous salue.
Brent Tilden. This is Mr. Hector Fellows.
You French, sir?
Sort of. Original. I'm from Quebec. But I left many moons ago. And you?
Oh. No. I came down from New York for a job. I'm a banker.
Banker?
An investment banker.
You're the fellows who never lend me money when I need it. And when I've got too much, try to lend me more.
And what do you do, Mr. Lafond?
Originally furs. But now sorts.
You okay?
Oh, my lord! The pesky nut! What a way to go, eh? Oh, thank you, sir. Yes, thank you. Algernon Wasp.
Hello, Ruprecht O'Keefe.
Well, hello, Mr. Keith. And pray tell me, what do you do?
I'm a shopkeeper.
Me too!
Big bank, sir.
Quite the sewer of the exotic.
And generate a lot of cash. Some nervous small-town bank could finish us in a bad year.
Small town? We handle more cash and cash equivalents than any bank south of Manhattan, including St. Louis. Almost all the Caribbean trade banks with us. We work with all the remaining...
Good evening to you, sir. Stay well.
We use a lot of cash, and we help finance the reconstruction projects after the war. We love big clients.
Evening, folks.
Our brother here in town has more cash reserves on site than any
so hard.
Entire country outside of Wall Street. And
evening, folks.
Well, bonjour.
How's it going? You sure brighten up the place.
Oh, merci.
How are you, ladies?
Bonjour, monsieur. How do you do?
Evening, ladies.
Why,
always
hello.
Nice to see a smile. How's it going with you?
Just lovely, thank you.
Hello. Good evening, ladies. Good for you.
How do you do? Take care of you.
It really is a beautiful heaven.
I got it from Mr. Wasp. He's the finest milliner in the state and quite the most interesting purveyor of the exotic. But don't tell anyone, sir. The women here are all desperate to know.
Thank you.
This is quite a town that you have here, Mr. Jameson.
Oh, I don't live here. I was here for the poker.
Oh, you play?
It's my weakness, my worst vice.
Perhaps you should have it whipped out of you like you advocate whipping the sin out of others.
Not whipping, sir, working, and besides, my vice is between me and my maker. I keep winning.
Every gambler says that, Mr. Jameson.
Yes, I know, but like I said, the next big tournament, which I will not be attending, is for a game too rich for my blood. I may be a knave, but I am a sensible knave.
Is that so?
Well, sure, I'm not a wealthy man. I run a prison. The old riverboat tournaments are for card sharks and rich fools. A really big stakes game attracts oilmen and such, like, from all over. My pockets are not deep enough for that.
You are a wise man.
I'm a conservative man, at least.
The fact is, since the war, the government has done an awful job of preserving.
Of course, I'm married, Miss Tweedy. But marriage is more business than romance.
And you're romantic, are you, Mr. Hawksbill?
I always have been. A true romantic. A dreamer. Why don't you let me show you someday?
And you think my cousin would appreciate that demonstration?
Your cousin is a cold woman. I'm a very lonely man.
And I am more than someone's blanket against the night's chill. Good evening, Mr. Hawksbill. Please stop pestering me.
Madam.
Sir?
I really do love Miss Tweedy. It isn't just champagne talking. Have you ever married the wrong woman, sir?
No. But I ain't married the right one either.
Well, I've made quite a habit of it.
How are you all doing?
How do you do, sir?
Evening, sir.
I apologize for that woman, sir. The last thing she needs is more champagne.
Hey, if she's having a good time.
I'm not sure she is, sir.
Well... Evening, ma'am.
Are you enjoying the party? How do you know the mayor?
I don't. I'm actually hoping to meet him.
He's definitely around. I just saw him. A man in demand.
I'm sure. Evening, folks. How are you all doing? Hi there. Evening, folks.
Hello there.
Hello. Hey there. Evening, gentlemen.
How do you do?
Good evening.
Hello, sir.
How do you do?
How are you all doing?
Bonjour.
How's it going?
As well as can be expected. What on earth?
You remind me of a feller I used to know.
How are you, ma'am?
Chérie.
How are you, ladies?
Sir.
Hi there.
Ah, hi there.
Sounding good, fellas. How do you do, ma'am?
Hello, dear.
How you doing?
Fine.
Evening all?
Just fine.
Why,
evening,
hello.
Folks.
So, anyway, well, mister. I heard that Judith Hawksbill has taken a lover.
Of course she has. That slippery fool has had that coming for years.
But that's not the interesting part. What's interesting is that her lover is a Pole.
A Pole?
A Russian. Something like that.
Like a Jew?
Oh, not that bad, but nearly. Excuse us, sir. We are having a private conversation.
Forgive me, ladies. I am new in town.
Excuse me, both of you, but I must just
if you
go
heard
speak
what
with
I
my
said about your
moment.
Opinions, I hope it didn't offend you.
It's mainly their politics I can't stand.
Not at all. I worked with an Irishman. He was a terrible person.
It takes all my gumption to sleep with Frederick here, and he's as capitalist as they come.
Why on earth are you doing
this? What's gotten into you? What is the meaning of this?
Hello, ma'am.
You know, I swear, half the men...
Evening, gentlemen.
Mais bonjour.
Gentlemen.
Why, hello.
Evening, gentlemen.
Content de vous gentlemen. Voir.
Good evening,
can I interest you in a glass of champagne?
Alfred Lafond, dear.
Mr. Gilbert Knightley.
You okay?
Oh, my lord! The pesky nut! What a way to go, eh? Oh, thank you, sir. Oh, yes. Thank you. Algernon Morris.
Hello. Tacitus Kilgore.
Hello, Mr. Kilgore.
Hello,
sir. What is it that, that you do?
I'm an adventurer.
Oh, me too. Pursuer of the exotic and the remarkable. An aesthete in this land of commonplace heathens. My card, sir.
Partners and I represent 20, well, more like 23% of all the trade heading south from...
Pay me a visit in my atelier. I must just go and purge. I intend to stay thin until I pass away. Good evening.
Not one I particularly like.
Thank you again, my fellow adventurer. And please, do pay me a visit at my atelier.
I'll try to.
Big thanks. Enjoy the rest of your evening. Stay away from the knots would be my advice.
Camilla McClair, wherever did you get that
Why,
hat?
That would be telling.
Oh, you. You're always so stylish.
I try. Mostly I fail, but I try.
And you ever met.
You're preaching again, Mrs. Wicklow.
And you're burying your head in the sand.
It really is a beautiful hat.
I got it from Mr. Wasp. He's the finest milliner in the state and quite the most interesting purveyor of the exotic. But don't tell anyone, sir. The women here are all desperate to know.
Demonstrable. I will not deny it simply because...
Can I help you, sir?
I'm intrigued, sir, to hear your arguments.
I am your...
Sounding good, fellas.
You're different, but you're neither my better nor my inferior, sir.
Okay, madam. I will not prove it by publicly thrashing you.
You're stronger than me, sure. But as civilized beings? Haven't we moved past that?
What is it? Can I help you?
Apparently not. Good evening,
ladies.
To you, sir.
Bonjour.
I will go find some other people to threaten to hit me.
Don't you think?
Well, I don't quite understand.
Well, you are not, it would seem, the only one.
I was in the army once.
Good for you.
What do you do now?
Well, I'm not quite a... I'm an American.
Yes, but what do you do?
Well, I'm in between jobs at the moment.
Oh, of course. Of course.
You shall be too, sir, if you don't sharpen up your morality.
I'm trying, sir. I'm trying.
Well, try harder. Much harder.
What would you like me to do? Hit the mayor myself?
Impudence. I see you still got that. But it takes more than a steady line and insults to succeed in newspapers. At least in mine.
Hello, then.
Good evening.
Prick.
Join yourself?
You know, I think those fellas were making fun of me. Anyway, what you found out?
Nothing too much yet.
I'll be glad when this is over.
Hi there, ma'am! Would you like some champagne?
Of course. Thank you, sir. You are quite the gentleman. Clearly not from this swampy hellhole. Thank you. Thank you. Ladies, I'll see you next week.
How are you all doing?
Hello, dear.
This is quite a town that you have here, Mr. Jameson.
Oh, I don't live here. I was here for the poker.
Oh, you play?
It's my weakness, my worst vice.
Perhaps you should have it whipped out of you like you advocate whipping the sin out of others.
Not whipping, sir, working, and besides, my vice is between me
Cowboy.
And my maker. I keep winning.
Every gambler says that, Mr. Jameson.
Yes, I know, but like I said, the next big tournament, which I will not be attending, is for a game too rich for my blood.
Of course, I'm married, Miss Tweedy. But marriage is more business than romance.
And you're romantic, are you, Mr. Hawksmith?
Always have been. A true romantic. A dreamer. Why don't you let me show you someday?
And you think my cousin would appreciate that demonstration?
It ain't complex, MU. And only an idiot like you, buddy, would try to make it so.
I will not deny your idiocy, sir, but perhaps now is not the time.
Typical pansy!
You are drunk, Ferdinand.
I'm not drunk, you fool. But this man loves darkies.
Hey, you are pretty drunk. Yeah, what say you and me cool off?
Bien le bonjour.
Get your hands off me.
Come on, sleep it off. Sit down and calm down. Count to 1,000. Then you can rejoin the party.
Oh,
Thank you, sir.
My pleasure.
Henri Lemieux. I hope you're enjoying my party.
The mayor.
Allegedly.
That's quite a place you got here.
It's not mine, and the city is horribly in debt, but we can still put on a good show. You know Evelyn Miller?
My lord. The writer?
Well, we seem to have another deranged drunkard on our hands.
Shall we?
Oh! My lord, they're fantastic!
Monsieur, please. Mr. Cornwall was quite insistent, I'm afraid. He shouted down the telephone for several minutes.
Mr. Cornwall is a horse's ass, and a bad horse.
I'm very sorry, sir.
It's not your fault. I'm a fool for trusting him. I'll come and sign it in a minute. Let me enjoy the fireworks.
Of course.
Let me say something about Cornwall. Yes, find out what.
Sure.
Are you looking for something, sir?
Sorry. I managed to get myself turned around somehow. Don't mind me.
Not a problem. Please enjoy the rest of the evening.
Sir,
howdy.
How do you do, ma'am?
Bien bonjour.
No problems?
Everything's fine. We have the place well secured.
Good. Mr. Bronte has a habit of wandering about and reading whatever he likes.
We're watching him and his men like hawks.
Thank you, Mr. Terrapin.
everything taken care? The telephone, it keeps ringing.
The mayor said he will sign later.
Marie! Marie! Find that little reprobate Jip and beat him! I will not have Standard slip in this house! Have you lost your mind? I said, have you lost your mind? Come here. Come here. Look at me. Look at me. Who do you think you are? This area is not meant for the likes of you. You know this. The standards in this house are slipping. This is a final warning to you, miss. A final warning. Now get out of my sight!
Mr. Leviticus Cornwall. Top secret. Extremely confidential. Very interesting.
Hello, mister.
Hello.
What's your problem?
Why don't you just
what
back
is
off?
Wrong with you?
Find anything? I think so.
Gentlemen, I think we're done here.
What did you find out?
There's plenty of money moves through here, of course, and I think I found out how we can grab some of it. A big bank. Real one, I mean. But not yet.
A city bank?
Maybe. And a stuffed one. We're gonna leave.
This way. Come on.
Yeah, good boy. Thank you.
It's all right, boy. Yep.
You crazy?
Help!
Out
just
of there.
Minding my own business.
What a joke.
I need your money, tough guy. Don't try nothing dumb.
You're about to get shot to pieces.
Shut up and do what I say.
You're gonna...
You're okay, boy. I was right.
Hey, hey. What is going on here?
Hey, is this your... Can't talk now. Mister?
No, no, I don't need to ride with nobody like you.
That's a strong-looking horse. Well, good luck to you. Hey, friend. Morning to you. Okay there? Partner?
Yeah. Yeah. You ready, boy?
That horse looks like a fine traveling companion.
Oh, I've been scratching the gravel today.
Yep. You okay, boy? Yep. Come on. Easy, boy. Gotta be done.
Paul's gonna take care of this. Give yourself up or die! Burn it out!
Thank you.
Can't be out again.
It's all right, boy. Sorry, boy.
job.
Out of.
Okay, boy. Stay here, boy. Thank you.
Easy, easy.
Let's go!
Hey, mister.
Hello there.
You must be pretty fast with that gun.
Come on. I know, girl, I know. Girl, easy. Hold up, dude. Idiot. Yeah. There we go.
Yeah.
Easy, whoa. Load up.
Hey, friend.
Hello.
How was it in town?
Pretty hot. There's quite a price on you boys.
It is so unfair. I didn't do nothing.
Well, they said you was wanted for murder.
It wasn't murder. It was self-defense.
And you killed a farmer?
Well, firstly, I would have, but he died before I could. And secondly, well, he had it coming. I don't like to say.
Well... ain't no business of mine. Here's the posters.
Thanks, partner.
That's that, then.
That's that.
Free at last.
Free from you, at least.
Well, not quite.
No?
We should... wait a while first, see if anyone's on our trail.
You're right. Too risky to split up now.
Two sets of eyes is better than one.
This ain't permanent, though. It's a temporary measure.
Well, right, right. Things blow over.
Then I'm done with you, Black.
I'm counting the hours, White.
I just get some food in my belly. I'm set, mister.
Yeah.
Can I help you?
Thanks for your help.
All right, then.
I'm gonna regret this, but you can shop here. You so much as look at me funny, though. All good. My favorite customer. All right, but if it has feathers or fur, keep it in the bag.
That's done.
Hey, that's too much.
Oh, good God.
This is all shit.
Law's gonna be looking for you. I don't wanna die. Help!
Someone help me!
Back the hell off of me!
Please, somebody help!
No, please.
Everything all right, sir?
Okay, better not be stolen, all right? Damn. Got a stock of these, huh?
Much appreciated. Lightens my load.
One of those days.
Lord above!
Ah.
And a very good morning to you. It's best I don't get involved.
Hey there, partner.
Morning, friend.
I've had better days, that's for sure.
Yeah, I hear that.
Ah, well, it ain't your problem.
Bye now.
Lord have mercy!
Oh, God.
your feet a look, but don't go get me.
Move out of the darn way.
It's all right, boy. There, boy. Yeah. There, boy. Have this, boy. Yeah, you all right there, boy? Hey there, can I have a word?
I'm only kidding around. Hey, boy. Come on now, boy.
Come take a look. All right, what do you want? Sure, don't go greasing up the pages, though. Listen, you won't take all day, will you?
Now this should be fun.
That gun seems to be well taken care of. Well, if that gun ain't shining, glad you take care of what's yours. Looks like you're taking care of that weapon. Good to see. That gun seems to be well taken care of. Well, if that gun ain't shining... Glad you take care of what's yours. Looks like you're taking care of that weapon. Good to see.
Hey, no customers over there. Mind yourself in here. That's
sure
it.
Thing.
No one steals from Desperini.
Could learn how to shoot,
shit,
fella.
Too damn close.
Hey, thank you.
Cussing son of a bitch.
You're a good boy. How you doing, boy?
Up for.
I could afford me a fine critter like that.
Thanks.
Good morning, partner.
What can I do for you?
In. I've got that, information you asked for. Do you want this now, then, or no?
Can you believe I just heard one of them demand an equal treatment to us whites? I mean, really.
Enough to start you drinking.
Right here for you when you're ready.
Well,
need something more specific this time. A wagon full of moonshine.
Well, you might just be in luck.
I knew I picked the right fella to speak to.
Hello,
partner.
How's about that?
Thinking of going after them, are you? I'd wager you're more than up to it.
Cars are still unkind. I've been waiting on that winning streak for some time.
That's just the way of things, I guess.
Know that feller is farming the swamp, or trying to, up by Siltwater Strand. He's a bad egg. Fancy that. I seen him coming and going here, and I never had an inkling.
Mark Johnson, the bounty. What I need to know? I gotta be wary of this one?
Just the other day, he took his son out on the rails. He seemed nice enough. Seemed, when quite clearly, he is not.
It can be confusing. Anything else about this old bounty you got, Johnson?
I don't know what to tell you. It's a funny one. Man looks to have put roots down, worked hard, he's part of the community. Almost. You never can know a person. And I say that as a married man.
I guess they ain't gonna turn themselves in.
They're looking for that one alive, I believe. Do your utmost.
Hello, sirs.
Hello,
hello, mister.
Hello.
Hi, folks.
Hi, mister.
Mister?
Some idiot tried breaking.
Hi.
Hello, ma'am.
This place is going to hell.
Mister?
Don't start no more crap around
this.
Here.
Hi there, mister.
Let the old turd go! I ain't working no more!
Hey there.
Why would you come back here? I'll beat you senseless!
You was put up on all sides. You done,
you're
you
harmless.
Piece of crap!
Ain't enough.
Who want?
There's no escaping now. You're surrounded.
You're gonna be committed to the earth in the state of Lemoyne, cocksucker.
Come on, Raiders, gonna stomp you out. You ain't nothing.
That all you got?
Three less of those idiots. Yep. Ma'am?
Don't you realize the sorrow you created
last hey there, partner. Easy, easy. Making a point with you.
How's it been?
No complaint.
No, that's nice.
Hey, boy. Yeah. Come on!
my eye in today, boy.
Mr. Morgan, to what do we owe the pleasure?
Been quite a ride the past few weeks.
You can say that again.
Well, just gotta keep moving on.
Okay.
I won't ask where all the blood came from.
All right. You ever miss home?
Sure. All the time.
Hi, Arthur.
There she is.
Hello, Arthur.
You look
Hi,
pissed
Hosea.
Off.
Hi, Hosea. No more than usual.
There he is. Miss O'Shea.
Hi, Arthur.
Okay. That looks fun.
I guess.
Well, don't let me interrupt you.
Let me know if you find candy.
How's things?
I found some candy in my pocket.
Great. Hello, Arthur.
My lady. Is the boy behaving himself?
For the most part.
Okay, I'll leave you two to it then.
All right then, Arthur. Hi, Arthur.
Hey there. Williamson?
Hello, Arthur.
Hey.
Hello, Mr. Morgan.
Hi.
You been bringing in money?
Of course I have.
Okay, well, good.
Sure, Morgan.
Why are you always under my feet, Williamson?
Hello.
Hi, Uncle.
Sorry, you all right?
Bill?
Hosea.
Yeah.
Mood seems pretty good around here.
It does.
Well, guess we should enjoy it while it lasts.
Sure, Arthur.
Mrs. Adler?
You gonna sit down instead of pacing about the place?
You okay?
Yep.
Any new leads?
I'm working on it.
Hey there. Bring me something soon if you can, Arthur.
Yeah, I hear you. You know, I'll just come back later. Charles.
Hi, Arthur.
Don't forget to go hunting, Mr. Morgan.
Yeah, I will.
All right, let's see what we got. Good job, Mr. Morgan. How are you on space in that bag of yours, Mr. Morgan? Just let me know if you need me to make you a new one.
Looks great, Pearson. Always good to see you.
You joining us, Dan?
Boy. Yeah.
Hold up there a moment. You doing all right, partner?
'Cause we ain't.
What brings you to this fine town? Profit and pillage?
I ain't here to cause trouble.
You looking for a volley of musket fire? This is Lemoyne Raider land.
Excuse me?
Toe the line, or I'll practice my knife work.
I'll leave when I damn well please.
All right, limber up! You ain't me.
You came close. Just close.
That is not good.
Porta miseria!
I must go to your daughter.
Yep. Hey! This is a big mistake. You know what? Just go.
Ti prego, non farlo.
That means stop, damn it. I'm giving you one more chance.
Oh, mio Dio! Criminal! Bandit! Help!
Easy now. Ah! Yeah. Hey, hey. Take more than that, boy. Ha! Whoa, back. Real good. Yeah. Come on now, boy. Go easy, boy. You okay, boy?
Whoa.
Howdy.
Yeah, you're a strong one, boy.
You look like the last guy stared at me funny. Damn bloody mess.
Don't you worry about it, okay?
me strength. Bureaucracy. The modern hell. And personally, I prefer the fiery pits. Hello? Oh, come now.
Yeah, they found Lucas knocked out for all his bare ass. I've seen it.
Excuse me.
Hey, do I know you?
Mr. Well, I believe we've met.
We have?
At that ghastly party.
Oh, Evelyn Miller.
Unfortunately so, Mr.
Arthur Morgan, at least sometimes.
Can I say something rude?
Sure.
The mayor thinks you robbed him. To be clear, he wasn't very upset about it. He rather liked you.
Okay.
Do you, well, I mean to say, can you steal things?
Is there a reason you're asking me to incriminate myself, Mr. Miller?
Well, I'm sorry. Have you met? This is Rainsfall, a great chief, and his son, Eagle Flies.
Gentlemen, we saw you in the wagon train crossing the river at Cumberland Falls. And at the party, you were upstairs.
You have great powers of observation.
As my people, if we are even a people anymore. We've fought hard. We've made peace treaties, and those treaties were broken. And we've been moved and punished and punished and moved.
I'm sure.
And now I am told we are to be moved again.
Clearly contravening the peace treaty signed 3 years ago.
This will lead to war.
No, my son, it will not. We cannot fight another war. They have got stronger. And we have become far weaker, Mr. Morgan.
Well, it's a bad business.
It's to do with oil. I know it is, but I need the proof. I believe there were some prospectors who were on their land a few months ago who have filed reports with Leviticus Cornwall and the state government claiming huge reserves of oil under their land.
So, you want me to try and steal it?
Obviously, they can't. And even more obviously, I would be useless. Listen, I realize that it is a ridiculous request, but we're very desperate.
Now, I'm not a do-gooder, Mr. Miller. Gentlemen, I'm very sorry for your predicament, but I'm a working man. I got problems of my own.
We will pay you very handsomely, Mr. Morgan.
How much?
I told you, they're all mercenaries.
There's a price on my head in two states, my friend. The government doesn't like me any more than it does you. Like you, I've been running for as long as I can remember. And like you, my time here is nigh undone.
We understand, and we will pay.
Thank you.
You meet my son in a couple of days near Citadel Rock, just west of the oil fields.
Okay.
We are very grateful for your help.
Gentlemen, that appointment with the senator. We should head over there.
It's a waste of our time. And his. No.
We must try everything. Come along.
Hello, Mr. Miller. The counselor wants to apologize. He can see you now.
We've been waiting I don't know how long.
Or next month, if you'd like to reschedule.
Come. Perhaps the senator won't mind waiting.
Yeah.
Hey, move it!
Whoa, look out!
Good to see you again. Okay, let's take a look at it.
Great.
Nothing quite like wearing your best day's work. Best trapper I ever knew? My fourth wife. Native. She'd find a trail while the bloodhound was still sniffing its own ass. Hell of a woman. Rest her soul. Done. Sure. Another one? Sure.
How are you?
Joseph.
Morning, mister.
Morning to you.
Excuse me, partner.
Morning, lady.
Good morning, sir.
Hey, mister.
Good morning.
Morning.
Wow. What I wouldn't give for a horse like this.
Thank you.
Good boy.
Something else?
You won't find fresher fruit right here, folks.
Not sure if this is a rumor or not, but they said the Cornwall Railroad and Central Union are in a big fight.
Sir?
Xinsang, Zousan.
Hello again. That was quick. Back awful soon.
Hi there. How can I help?
Hey, kitty.
Ladies.
Good morning.
Howdy, y'all.
Good morning to you.
You'll see.
Good day so far.
Mm-hmm.
If you don't mind me saying,
You look lovely today.
That boss was a day late paying.
Morning,
he said since he told me in advance
this
was okay.
Ma'am.
Morning, mister.
Good morning.
And hello again. Thanks.
Matching sets of clothes made right here. Can you move out of the way?
Buenos dias.
Solves a problem.
Help me. Help me.
What the hell happened?
Just let the law handle this. Don't worry.
Damn it. Easy there, friend. You just go around beating the tar out of anyone you please?
You really want to mess with me?
I just got heated, that's all.
Think twice before you trouble me again.
Morning. Yep.
Hey there, mister. Look out.
Good morning, sir.
Get the floor to stop moving.
Thank you.
One moment, please. This is extremely delicate.
Hey.
There. Oh, wonderful. Algernon Wasp, purveyor of the exotic and the exquisite. Enchanté.
Tacitus Kilgore.
How can I help you? May I interest you in a hat, perhaps? Yeah. How about a nymph? I import them from Brussels. The idiots in this town all want Italian nymphs, but the Italians make the coarsest of marble. I mean, quite frankly, the Baroque is an abomination. Belgium. Now that is a land for the connoisseur.
Oh, yes. Yeah, as I always say. But, you know, I'm not really a nymph kind of man.
Oh, of course, too ephemeral. You want something, more tangible, more gothic. I also make corsets. Would you like a corset? I always wear one.
No. I don't think so. Yeah, I ride a lot of horses. The whalebone might stick in.
Well, a cup of tea.
Sure.
And what is it you do, Mr. Kilgore? Are you a gentleman of leisure? An aesthete? An artist?
Well, I suppose I'm kind of an adventurer.
Ha! Oh, yes, of course you are. Here, be careful with the china, sir. It is French.
Not Belgian?
No. They are Philistines in that area, not to be trusted. Youth, eternally preserved in marble, is more their specialty. I fear China will always elude them. Now, why are you here exactly?
I don't know.
You're an adventurer. A wanderer, a lost soul cast out from heaven?
Sure.
Well, I do pay exceptionally well for certain objects needed for my art.
You do?
I do. Exceptionally well.
Well, what do you need?
Let's see. Right now, I have a couple of commissions. I need at least 15 egret plumes. Good ones, obviously. I also need 15 assorted orchids. Here's a list.
Okay. I will see what I can do. Thanks for the tea.
Thank you, Tacitus. It'll be very worth your while.
Good morning, ma'am.
Good morning, sir.
Nice round here. I'm kind of new to these parts.
Ah.
Bonjour, monsieur.
We must enjoy this temperate spell. As long as it isn't the rain.
There, boy.
Huh?
Yeah.
Being out here is great, till I run into people.
Okay there, boy. Yeah. Come here. Hey,
now.
It's over. Creep up on you, you know.
Oh, Mr. Morgan.
How are you?
Well, sir.
What are you working on?
Do you know anything about alligators?
Only the basics. Avoid them wherever possible.
Well, did you know that in the last 50 years, we've killed 90%?
You say that like it makes you sad.
They're beautiful creatures.
Let's see how you speak when one of them's got you in a death row.
Yes, I will make some creature a very happy lunch one of these days.
Let's try and avoid that from happening today, hmm? Well, you stay there, you'll get a great shot, then you'll get eaten.
What a way to go.
Why don't we take this boat out, and I'll protect you. Come on, get in the boat, he'll be fine.
Well, if you really think that's necessary.
You carry on shooting from that bank, you're gonna wish them wolves had eaten you.
Really?
Yes. The 10% who survived, they're the nasty ones.
All right, then. Oh, I saw a movement to the north of us. Oh, and to the west. Oh, and to the northwest, there.